This is how we do it. We walk over here, we say, kettle. And kettle. That whining, okay, that whining makes us freeze, doesn't it? Oh my God, where did the dog? You put a dog in a crate, it whines all night. Right? If it sees another dog that it doesn't know, it might scream like we're killing it. Don't let the dog object to us, which sounds really cold and really mean and really abusive, I know. It's about the mean guy, remember? So, how many times do we open up a crate when our dog is excited to see us? Who does that? Anybody? Anybody? Nobody. Always in my show. Dogs don't come out of crates unless they're calm. But I'm not going to tell them to be calm. Sit, wait, sit, calm down, calm down. And I'm not going to be like, ah, I'm happy to see you. I haven't been around for 5 minutes. They're happy to see us the first thing in the morning. They're happy to see us if we go out for groceries. They're happy to see us if we come home from work. Of course they are. But if I come running in, woohoo, I'm home, Papa's here. You can get the dog to jump up and then pee themselves. Of course they're excited. This is how we do it. I'm not going to tell them to sit, because if they don't sit, we're like, normally the leash collar not on the dog. This is for demonstrational purposes only. Please don't try this at home. The dog is calm. Okay, I'll let you out. The dog goes towards the door. Sometimes they'll rush to go out the door. They'll slam the door in their face. You're not going to hurt the dog. I didn't tell you to come out. Just because there's an open door, that doesn't mean anything. Just because there's an open door, remember, car door, sliding door, crate door, doesn't mean a thing. So just because I open the door, that's meaningless. So this might take you 3 or 4 times. I assure you, the highest bouncing dog will just look at you like, Jeff, what do you want me to do? Ha! And your dogs won't say that because your name's not Jeff, but insert your name here. So open the door. What do I say? Okay. Okay means now you come out. What happens if the dog doesn't want to come out? What do I do? Throw a treat on the ground? No. I put a leash on it and I say, let's go. Please. When you have a dog, there's a show out there. Remember all the dogs that came from Michael Hicks? 52 pit bulls trained to fight, 42 are living in homes right now, just to let you know. 42 dogs are living in homes, and one dog is bitten. They've all been in a home at least a year. Now one trained dog has bitten anybody in a year. Right? Half of Paris Hilton's chihuahuas have all bitten somebody. No, seriously, they haven't. The pit bulls don't attack young kids, and they just don't. I won't get a lot of pit bulls. So, what do we do when there's a scene in one of the Best Friends videos, not to knock Best Friends, I mean, they're doing a good job, where the dog wouldn't come out, was so petrified, it would not come out of the crate. So they sat down in front of it and talked to it soothingly and tried to coax it. And when you say to a dog, come on out, come on out, come on out, let's go. You're saying to the dog, you're doing a really good job being a really big wimp and I'm being afraid. What do? You take a leash, you make a little slip knot, throw it over its head, and you say, let's go. You take the crate, you dump it over. I know that sounds mean, but guess what? When you dump it over and you say, let's go, I assure you on day three, that dog, that's why our kids can't count. On day three, the dog's like, hey, let's go. I'm really big with nervous dogs. What do I do? Hey, if you want to sit in the play yard and hide underneath a table while when it's free time, go ahead. That's your choice. But when it's time to work, we work. And when we work, I'm going through the process of what the finished product is going to be like. That's why we lift on like this, we walk. Who does not want a dog to be off-leash trained? Does anybody not want their dog to be off-leash trained? Exactly. That's the goal. The goal is to have the dog that's off-leash trained. Okay, let's talk about signs. Can I get this one? I think there's one that's this one. Okay. I'm a big advocate of the prong collar. I personally believe that every shelter system in America should train a dog on a pronghound. They look barbaric. I put them up to my neck and I pull them. Right? And I got some videos and I'll sell them after. I got high heels on, fishnet stockings. They look barbaric. Of course they do. I'll be the first to admit they look barbaric. A lot of times, a lot of people like to throw, science says these are mean and abusive. Science says this, science says that. So I'm like, what science is everybody talking about? So I found the actual scientific study that everybody likes to quote. This is a study out of Switzerland, 1992, Andrea Holloway. They said, and what they did was they did 400 dogs. And they said, we'll give you free medical attention if you come bring your dog in, because we want our chiropractor, the canine chiropractor, to look at it. Great, free medical, free. They come in, 63% of those dogs had neck and spinal injuries. Of the 63%, 91% had in their life, it was getting a harsh jerk. So they determined that pinch collars and choke chains are bad. The problem is, the study only studied choke chains. This wasn't in the study. There's nothing in this whole study that says anything about prong collars. People just put it in. They just put it in. They just add it to it because it's metal and it looks barbaric and they assume. A properly used prong collar doesn't jerk, tug, or pull. Ever. How many times have we seen dogs in front of us like this? Even on a nylon collar. That causes tracheal damage. There is a study out there where they autopsied 100 dead dogs. 50 of them were, their whole life worked on prong collars, 50 on choke chains. Again, 47 or 48 of the choke chain ones had massive amounts of tracheal and neck damage, which supports the study. Three that used prongs had damage. Three. That was another scientific study. So the science that says these are bad is wrong. That's not dog training. Always looking for his birth certificate. If our dog walks us, our dog walks all over us. The structured walk is the most important part of a good training system. I don't care if you've got 5 acres. I don't care that your dogs run free. If we don't walk our dogs, we don't train our dogs. You can't hire me unless you commit to walking your dog. The walk is everything. 8 dog walks I do all the time. I'm not using strength, I'm using technique. That's Romy when she was probably 3 with a dog. Proper walking eliminates jumping, pulling, lunging, barking, biting, barking, aggressive nervous behavior. A lot of people out there say that prong collars make dogs nervous and aggressive. I get a lot of hate mail, and one of the most popular things is when I get a dog that just comes into me and it's sitting next to me, and I might have a prong collar on it, and someone will say, oh, you're making the dog nervous. No, the dog was nervous before I got it. I didn't make the dog nervous. You're making the dog aggressive. No, I didn't. The dog is here because it's aggressive. Not because of me. It's punishment. A lot of people like to use the word punishment. Anybody want to have Romy stand here so we can yell at her for punishing the dog? It's a joke. So heal your dog. Heal Red Man. Here's what happened. So Red Man, when I picked Red Man up, he was so excited to be with me, he actually dragged me to the truck. So this is Red Man. Now, when a dog is pulling, we're not training. When a dog is pulling, we're not training. The leash is relaxed. A lot of times people get freaked out because they see this barbaric pinch collar on a dog, but he doesn't hurt the dog. It sits there. Now, when the way we properly walk in God, when we say heel, heel means at my side, at my pace. At my side, at my pace. Okay? At my side, at my pace. When I come to a stop, I expect all dogs to do this. Not that. This. 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 When a dog is walking next to us like this, they're not pulling, they're not lunging, they're not marking, they're not sniffing. Let's go. They're not sniffing. How many people have dogs that sniff and mark? That's what they're supposed to do, right? Now they walk. What are you doing? Are you marking the neighborhood so that when you see somebody come in your neighborhood, you're going to growl at them or lunge at them? This is my neighborhood. I pay taxes. You're a dog. Why aren't dogs supposed to mark in the wild to mark their neighborhood? So until these dogs start paying taxes, we don't let them mark. Sniffing. We don't let them sniff. The walk is for exercise and training. Exercise. When can my dog sniff and mark? When it's off leash, running on the beach, in the woods, in the open fields. Do whatever you want to do, as long as you come back to me. The walk is exercise and training. I've got clients that it takes them half an hour to walk around the block. Once they learn how to properly walk a dog, they do it in 5 minutes. The walk is everything.
Because my running mics all the time.
Place. Who has dogs? Who has dogs that beg at the table? Two people. Who has dogs that rush the door when somebody comes over, jump on everybody? Who has dogs? Oh, the kids. Get the kids. Oh, yeah, get the kids. Come get the dogs. Who's got young children in the house but they can't have a dog interfere with them because the dog steals their toys? This is place. This is place. That's place. That's place. I do a lot of horse farms. Of course, dressage community. Thinks I do a good job of leash work. Hey girls, come on up. Come on. Let's go. Quick. Okay. Pretend you're excited to be here and sit right here. This is Romy and Clover. I've got six human daughters. And this is six. How old are you now, Romy? Four? She's four. Three ex-wives. I can't keep track of all my kids. So right now, if they had all their like dolls, little Polly Pockets and puzzles and all kinds of stuff. But if the dog is in place, I can have my kids here too. And if they have little food in their hands, the dog's not going to eat the food. This is the best thing for children and dogs. I want to include dogs in my life. I don't want to exclude dogs. I want to include dogs. That's the place of the trade show.